Hey, what's up YouTube? It's ICU. Today, Apple's released iOS 13.2.3, and in this video, we're going to talk about jailbreaking specifically and what to do based on which device you have and whether or not you should update. So let's rip the band-aid right off. If you have an iPhone 10 or lower, you will be able to jailbreak almost immediately with Checkra1n. However, if you try currently with the latest beta as of recording this video, 0.9.5, it's going to say something like this. Sorry, iPhone, whatever iPhone you have or device you have, is supported, but iOS 13.2.3 is not. Supported versions are 12.3 through 13.2.2. Now, because this is based on the all-powerful Checkmate exploit, and it's actually a boot ROM exploit that exists in the CPU of the device itself, it can't be patched by Apple, and Checkra1n will be updated to include support for 13.2.3. It's not a matter of if, rather when, and I very much expect it to be released, if not today, then sometime this week, 100%. However, you will not be able to jailbreak any device powered by an A12 or A13 processor with Checkra1n because it utilizes that Checkmate exploit that was patched in A12. So, the iPhone XS series, iPhone XR, and up. And of course, that also extends to the iPhone 11 series. So if you have any of those newer devices or an iPad powered by an A12 CPU, so basically any iPad that came out in 2018, you're not going to be able to jailbreak with Checkra1n. That's just how it is, but do not fret. There is going to be a jailbreak for you. It's only a matter of time because Checkra1n allows for a permanent jailbreak environment. New security research is now being actively worked on. New kernel vulnerabilities are being discovered and actually patched in iOS, the last one being in iOS 13.2. So there will be a jailbreak for A12 and A13 eventually. We just don't know when. So bookmark this page right here. It's going to be the very first link down below in the description for now, and it says immediately whether or not the jailbreak is released. So you can bookmark it, check back regularly, and this red no will change to a green yes once the jailbreak is out. As far as updating goes, this is the interesting thing. If we look at Apple's security updates page, you'll notice that for both iOS 13.2.3 and 13.2.2, they say that this update has no published CVE entries, which stands for common vulnerabilities and exposures. See, iOS 13.2 actually patched something that was very critical, meaning it existed in 13.1.3 and lower, that could lead to a semi-untethered jailbreak, which means that you would not need the assistance of a computer to reboot and use your jailbreak stuff. So it's different than Checkra1n. All devices would, in theory, be able to take advantage of a jailbreak like this, including even the older ones and the brand new ones. So if you're on 13.1.3, avoid updating to 13.2.3 like the plague. However, if you're already on 13.2.x, it's not the end of the world if you do update to 13.2.3, but I really, honestly, truly do recommend avoiding it just because it's always best policy to remain on as low of a firmware as possible in case something like iOS 13.2 happens that patches a previously known new kernel vulnerability. That way you can kind of just get in the habit of staying on as low of a firmware as possible. You already know that you're probably not going to update, so you can maintain those habits and that behavior. But if you update, it's not the end of the world. As long as you're on something like iOS 13.2 or higher, you're not going to really be missing out too much. It doesn't seem like, according to Apple's security page here. Of course, things could always change and a new zero day could drop that Apple hasn't been made aware of, but that is highly, highly unlikely, especially with the trend of the jailbreak community over the last couple years. But that's everything you need to know right now. The iPhone 10 and lower will be able to jailbreak via a Checkra1n update that will come very soon. The iPhone XS and up should definitely stay on whichever firmware they're on and not update and just wait. Subscribe if you have yet to. I'll keep you fully notified and in the loop of any and all jailbreak developments. And until next time, this is ICU signing out.